Hello YouTube. We're looking at the IDEAL Sidekick model number 96453 solid state DC cassette tape recorder from approximately the early 1970s. This machine is an example of self-improvement because the specifications that came with the machine, which are in the little booklet here, and you're going to be able to see that in a screen in just a moment, are terrible. Yet I was able to bring this machine back to life and to work better than the original specifications. Let's take a look at the functions. We have an eject button here, which opens the cassette door and will pop out the tape. We have a record button located here. There is a control here that looks a lot like a Philips Norelco type control system. It's the standard T control where you push it forward and then you hold it this way for rewind and this way for fast forward. And there's a nice little red volume control knob. Now when I saw this machine, I thought, maybe this is a Philips type mechanism. It has a metal grill over the speaker, and it's actually a much better color red than what we're seeing in the video. And it has this nice black and red case that we can see, two-tone case, and a carry strap here. Now, inputs and outputs are simply a microphone with a remote and an earphone output. There is nothing else anywhere on this machine. No line input, no power input. So it has to run off the batteries, which are located here, and it takes 4C size batteries. I have the microphone plugged in. We're ready to do a test recording. Everything is automatic on this. You simply press the record button. Engage it in play, turn on your switch, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, testing 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test of the IDEAL Sidekick cassette tape recorder, DC bias. She sells seashells by the seashore. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. See how that came out?
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test of the IDEAL Sidekick cassette tape recorder, DC bias. She sells seashells by the seashore. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers.
So you could hear some sibilance because of the DC bias, but overall it's not too bad. And the tone is pretty good for this machine. Now, one of the things you'll notice is that when I put it in fast forward, see how slow that is? It's a very slow fast forward. The rewind is much better. Why is that? Keep watching the video and find out when we look inside the IDEAL Sidekick cassette tape recorder. We're looking at the underside of the IDEAL. You can see, obviously, here is the amplifier board. Here's the motor. Here's the capstan flywheel. Here's a little speaker. It's a very compact system. Now, look very carefully at this and tell me if you can see what is missing. There is something that's very obviously missing when you compare this to the bottom or the inside of a standard Philips Norelco type cassette recorder, even an Iowa or a Sony. What's missing is there is no friction clutch mechanism anywhere here. The motor drives the capstan and that's it. Nothing else interferes with the action of the belt. Now, why did they do that? Well, a very simple reason, which is not obvious here because of the repair that I had to make. This machine used a flat belt from the motor to the capstan. The flat belt obviously stretched and wore out, so I had to replace it, but I didn't have a flat belt, and that's why it's a little confusing because I used a square belt. Now, obviously a square belt has a flat surface on it, consequently, I figured it would probably work. It was a little bit risky because the pulley here and the capstan pulley is slightly rounded to center the flat belt, and so when I put in the square belt, it actually has to sit on one side or the other of that little dimple that they put into the pulley. But it does work, so let's take a look at it. I've got it in fast forward now. It's going to look the same whether I put in fast forward, rewind, or play. And there we have it. The motor has an electromechanical governor control. Obviously it's a tiny little speaker. And the quality actually is pretty good on the inside of this. Look at the quality of this amplifier board. If they don't have a friction clutch mechanism here, where is it? Keep watching the video, you'll find out. As we can see here, this machine is very, very different from a Philips Norelco type mechanism. All of the mechanical transport is handled by this belt, which is driven by a pulley on the capstan itself. Now you can see the belt runs around here to this idler, then it comes across, goes over a pulley that's on the lower part of the take-up table. That is the friction clutch mechanism. There's a piece of felt between the lower part and the upper part of the table. Then it goes past this tensioning pulley, then it wraps over here around the rewind pulley, and then comes back to the capstan. Let's take a look at this in motion. First we're going to look at rewind. Now you notice that this pulley here comes over, disengaging the belt from the take-up table so that it can spin freely. In fast forward, it spins away from the feed table, and then in play, it also moves away from the feed table, but the friction clutch mechanism is able to work. Now, notice that in fast forward, nothing is done to change the speed of the take-up table. It's just simply not engaging the pinch roller. This is why it's slow. Whenever it is put into any function, the belt returns to press against either this feed table or the take-up table. So they didn't need to put brakes in. They're actually using the power from the capstan to brake the system. We go to fast forward. You see it's pretty slow, and now we know why. Go to rewind. It's a little faster. And then in play.
IDEAL cassette tape. Thank you for watching the video about me, the IDEAL Sidekick cassette tape recorder. As you can see, self-improvement and personal growth is possible even for a vintage machine. We hope you enjoyed the video, and please keep watching ClydeSight Channel. There are more machines on the way.